Mark McDaniel, professor of psychology and education at Washington University in St. Louis. Spacing is a technique that's alternative to the common practice of presenting one particular topic or kind of content in one session. Spacing would take the same amount of time that you would spend on one lesson and divide that time into smaller chunks. And these smaller chunks would be distributed across several days or several weeks rather than presenting the material at once. And the research shows that spacing produces robust advantages in retention of material and sometimes in transfer of material. So an example would be an experiment that was done in a middle school biology classroom, I'm sorry, a middle school science classroom. And the lessons involved some biology topics, one of which was mitosis. The researchers took the mitosis lesson, which generally was presented in one class, and during the lesson, terms would be repeated and so on, and divided the amount of time that was generally spent on that lesson, took some portion of the time, and spent it on mitosis after an animal reproduction section. Then a little bit more of that time was spent after another lesson, plant reproduction. So the same amount of time spent on mitosis, but in one case, it's presented in one lesson as it typically would be. In another case, that information is sectioned off into smaller units of time that are distributed among other kinds of topics. And it turns out that 3 weeks after presentation of these lessons, that these middle school kids were 50% better on average at answering questions about the particular terms, generating the terms to fill in the blank, and I think more impressive in answering essay questions that ask the kids to describe what mitosis is and to illustrate the process. So again, the same amount of time is spent on these terms in this unit, but in one case it's spaced over several different lessons, if you will, or reviewed. There are little reviews across other lessons. In the other case, it's the more traditional method of presenting everything in one session and then moving on to other topic. I think in education we can distribute and space our instruction much more than we're doing now to really tremendous benefits. Now, it's going to be a little bit of a challenge for teachers because they're used to spending all their time on one topic and one lesson. But they don't need to spend any more time. They just have to think a little bit about reserving some time for a particular content and bring it back up a week later, 2 weeks later, and so on throughout the semester. And this is going to promote much better retention and learning. You can even see the effects in motor learning, skill learning type of situations. For example, practicing an instrument, it's better to practice in a spaced fashion, 30 minutes a day for the week, rather than 2 1.5-hour sessions throughout the week. And in fact, college baseball teams have used this principle to help improve the batting proficiency of their hitters. At Cal Polytech, a study was done in which hitters practiced hitting 15 fastballs all at once, 15 curveballs, and 15 changeups, three times a week over a 5-week practice session. And that was compared to a spaced or distributed practice situation where the hitter would hit a fastball, then maybe a curveball, then maybe a changeup, then maybe another changeup, then a curveball. So the practice on 15 of each kind of pitch is spaced over the whole session, and these hitters were much better at who got the spaced practice than the hitters who got the mass practice. So in virtually every kind of content you can think about, spacing the presentation or practice of material produces much better retention than massing the practice. Now, some teachers are going to ask, it's a good question too, well, what are the time frames in which I should space the material? The optimal spacing, more or less, for promoting retention at 30 days is about a review every 6 days. So you can see if you want to retain things for about a year, really we ought to be spacing and reviewing content every couple months in our classrooms. There are some interesting reasons why spacing is going to promote retention. And spacing the information now is presented once you've forgotten and once the original lesson has left awareness. So on the next presentation, you have to retrieve the information, you have to get it out of long-term memory, and that then creates a more focused, a more attentive, a more engaged interaction with the material on the second and the third presentations. Moreover, these second and third presentations are coming in a different context. They're coming in a context in which additional information has been learned, and so these spaced presentations allow what we would call variable encoding, chances to encode the information in different ways, get different perspectives on it, understand it a little bit differently, relate it to prior knowledge. All of these things are instrumental in learning and good retention. Spacing fosters that. If our goal in education is for long-term retention of material, that is, if our goal is that the kids learn information that they can retrieve and use a year later, 2 years later, 3 years later, we really ought to be spacing our practice.